Thank you, Professor Parvis. Now it is the time for the presentations of the current and former students. We will start with Leyla Issebar, who is currently a PhD student in metrology. Thank you, Leyla.
Thank you, everybody. Good afternoon, and thank you, Giovanni, for your introduction. I am Leyla Issebar. I'm currently a PhD student in metrology at Politecnico di Torino. And I would like to present to you also the research group I work with, is the Cometa Lab, where Cometa is an acronym for corrosion measurement tools for artifacts. As you can see from this slide, we are a group made of researchers with a very multidisciplinary background. Indeed, this allows to combine all our different expertise in our work, starting from chemistry, electronic engineer, material engineering, and also material science. Between all the research areas that Professor Parvis introduced, I work within the applied metrology for health, energy, environment, and cultural heritage area. In particular, the principal aim of my research activity is to study the corrosion behavior and to develop an in situ multi-analytical characterization and protection methodology for artifacts that are of interest in the cultural heritage field. To achieve this principal aim, I'm following two lines of research. The first one regards in particular the performing of monitoring campaign that allows us to assess the conservation state of an artifact. This can be done thanks to our instrumentation. We have different instrumentation that are portable. So it's like having a portable laboratory. We have both a portable commercial instrumentation like X-ray fluorescence, electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, Raman spectroscopy, and also instrumentation for photogrammetry. Then we have also instrumentation and tools that were developed by the research group at Politecnico di Torino, like a 3D printed electrochemical cell that can be used in situ and without damaging an artifact, and also 3D printed sensor for temperature and humidity that allows us to perform environmental monitoring. Then, one part of the research regards the design and development of a 3D standard for photogrammetry procedure assessment. During these 3 years of the PhD, there are many training and research activities. This allows you to travel, for example, and these are the places I had the chance to visit since I began the PhD. For example, there are PhD external training activities like the summer schools, but also you will have the opportunity to travel in order to participate in conferences. Conferences are a really interesting occasion for you to present your work, but also to get to know new researchers and their works. And there are also the occasion to apply for student travel grant or awards to participate in student contests. These are the one I get the opportunity to won in these years. And I would like to underline one in particular, the FC Young Researcher Travel Grant, to show you that these grants many times are a money prize that allows you to spend a period of research abroad. In this case, I will have the opportunity to spend some time at the CNRS Chimie Paritech Laboratories in Paris. Finally, there are also the external projects that you can be involved in. Indeed, part of my research is conducted in the Polito laboratories, but a fundamental part is conducted outside. Indeed, we cooperate with the Centro Conservazione e Restauro La Venaria Reale. With this group, we develop indeed the 3D standard for photogrammetry, and with the Collezione Gori, it's a private collection of works of art in Pistoia, we perform in situ measurements. Then the research group in these years joined many different laboratories to conduct my research. Finally, besides the course and research activity, there are other activities that you can join during these 3 years. For example, you can be a teaching assistant. In my case, I was an assistant in the chemistry course at Politecnico, and this was I found this activity very interesting, formative, and it's also a chance to get some extra money besides the PhD scholarship. Then you can get to know many students and join students groups. For example, I joined the EEE Women in Engineering Affinity Group as a secretary. This group was funded last year, and also the EEE Student Branch Polito as a member. I would like to thank all the students in this group that also helped to organize the event, and also to invite you to join it if you are interested. Thank you very much.